Welcome to Football FanBox. I am your host, John Hightower, and this is the show that celebrates everything that's football in Las Vegas. All right, welcome to my favorite segment. It's time for the debate. Now, first question. Based on what we've seen so far in this year, who are your two Super Bowl teams and who comes out the winner? We're going to start this off with Mr. Morlon Greenwood.
One thing that people don't necessarily take in consideration are incentives. You've got a lot of players that they need to hit their numbers in order for a financial payout. So regardless if you're 0-11, 0-12, or 16-0, at the end of the day, you get a paycheck. And depending on your contract, that's what incentivizes you to play. And again, if you're on an 0-11 team and you're trying to tank the season, you might as well just quit. Football's competitive. You're supposed to go out and win. And if you don't have the heart to go out and win, retire.
I guess let me give you a better MVP pick that most probably will not see coming.
Okay.
Josh Allen, Buffalo.
Bulls, quiet 7-2.
Off the Buffalo roster.
A quiet 7-2. You're right.
Nice.
I'll go with that.
Where are the Buffalo Bills without Josh Allen?
They're 6-3.
Well, I have to disagree with Ainsley and Kyle. I think Derek Carr has proven himself. He's completed 70% of his passing. He's not very healthy. His line wasn't very healthy. You get him a healthy line, he's got the receivers, he's got the running backs. I think he's got a good shot next year. I keep Carr, absolutely.
Luis, one question.
Yes, sir.
In the last 3 years, how many playoff wins do they have?
That team has earned the right to
have that
bye week. You know, they have worked throughout the year. And they have proven that they're the top team in the NFL. So why not?
Absolutely. It's a meritocracy. You want to be the best, beat the best. And if you can't beat the best, then you play. And that's the way it goes. And if you don't like it, you know, there's a chess club, there's the band, the Rotary Club. Depending on what city you live in, there's a million things you could do other than try and win a football game.
Unless you've been there, there's no way you can explain it. It's almost like being in the military and being in combat. You can read stories, but the minute that linebacker hits him in his back and lifts him up and puts him underneath the turf, he's never been hit like that. I can guarantee he's never been hit like that in his life. And those are times when he's going to make a real commitment to either get better at this sport or start getting good at golf.
Hello, my name is John, and these are the winning picks for the upcoming week. I have the Raiders handling their business by -3. I have Arizona -2 getting that win.
This week, I got the Raiders -3. I got the Giants -6. The Cleveland Browns with my man, Baker Mayfield, -6.5.
Hello, my name is Don. I'd like to say hi to my beautiful wife, Candy. And here's my this week's picks in football this week. I like Kansas City -7.
Bills -2 over the Steelers. Tampa Bay -6.5 over Minnesota. Good luck on your picks.
In the next few weeks, the NFL Alumni Las Vegas chapter, Football FanBox, the Morlon Greenwood Foundation, the Nevada Youth Football Leagues will be honoring the people that put their community first. These are the police, the nurses, and the first responders. These will be the first recipients of this award. And this week's Community Service Award goes out to Tina Edwards, a nurse that's in San Diego. We want to present the Community Achievement Award to Sergeant Brennan Jackson for the great work that he's done for the Army, for our country, and for our community. Congratulations. And the Hero of the Week Award goes to Marilyn Jordan for the great work that she is doing in the community and for our country. Marilyn, congratulations.
Stay safe.